Hello, I'm George Dobell. Welcome to a special Polite Enquiries with arguably the most powerful, charismatic man in world cricket. That's right, Jarrod Kimber is back. And we've also got Lalit Modi here. In fact, we're at Lalit's house. It's not my hotel room. You might be confused by the
minibar. I don't think it's his house, it's his crib.
It's his crib, which is about the same size as Suffolk. English Nick, what achievement are you most proud of from the IPL?
The biggest achievement for me in IPL is that I'm able to change people's lives. I take the example of Ishan Sharma, who went out in the first auction, close to $2 million. Ishan used to live in a small little hut with his parents in a one-bedroom apartment. But that kid went on to earn unprecedented amount of money and was unprecedented in that, and allowed him to change his life. Allowed him to change his life for the betterment. Allowed him to think big. And secondly, he could never dream about sitting in the room with Shane Warne, having a drink with Sachin Tendulkar, being on the same bus with him. And to me, so when I see that, you know, my heart leaps out and see how many thousands of families' lives have changed and inspired a whole amount of youth around the world who didn't ever think that they could ever make money in cricket.
Presumably you make quite a lot of money from it as well, though, which is a pleasant byproduct.
No, I don't make any money because the money I made is from the BCCI and the money is for goes to charity. So to me, all my time, which nobody understood, I gave my time free of cost. I never charged for the IPL. I used to work for the IPL. It was a dream of mine to build a product, and not many people in life realize their dream.
What does the IPL need to do to remain fresh and innovative?
What I did today is obsolete tomorrow already. And for me, it was all about innovation, innovation, innovation. Whether it was in the filming technology, whether it was using spider cams or using, you know, DRS, or to be using hotspot, or to be using, you know, all the different technology that I was always adding.
Well, was county cricket the inspiration up to a point?
Never been.
Just because?
I've never understood county cricket. I don't understand why that you have such an arc. You developed the game in this country, but you haven't done anything with the game.
Unfortunately. Well, we mentioned 2020 and 2003. I wonder whether that was...
But then, and nobody heard about it.
An inspiration.
My first pillar that I built the IPL on was to bring the marriage between cricket and Bollywood. You got more 50% of the women and children are the viewers of IPL, and we are hoping that the same fan base is able to translate into Test cricket, ODIs, and across the country.
Cricket Monk asks, can't the IPL do well without cheerleaders? And he's got a point, hasn't he? Because the sort of person who's attracted to a game by cheerleaders isn't necessarily the sort of fellow you want at a family game.
The cheerleaders in a lot of sports around the world. So I wanted to be controversial, and I wanted to be front page news and breaking news. So what better way to be front page news and breaking news when I had a giant like ICL who had all the money and all the broadcasting? I had nothing.
Imagine
so,
that, Kimber.
So as far as I'm concerned, to me, controversy was an extremely essential part of my product building. Some like it, some don't like it. But I like it. I put it in there. And if there will be controversy, great.
If you started a women's IPL, would you have male cheerleaders?
Absolutely.
There? I am available.
And so am I, so no problem.
Yaps9 asks, now that you have the government of your choice, when are you going home?
I'm coming home soon, very soon.
Are you missing it?
I'm missing it, of course. Every day, May 12th, this year was my fourth year in London.
You're not slumming it here, which is good.
But you've got to understand that I have a business that's a multi-billion dollar business.
Right.
We run a very large business. We're the world's second largest manufacturer of cigarettes in India. We're the world's largest manufacturer of insecticide and fungicide in the world. We have a very large...
It's not the sexiest business, is it?
Cricket never added to my lifestyle. I only added to cricket.
We've got a nice question here. Two on a similar thing. One from Martish Subash. And one from Freddie Wild. Where would you take Srini on a dinner date? And when was the last time you had a drink with him?
First and foremost, I don't have a drink with him. I've never had a drink with him ever in my life.
Never.
I don't drink.
So is there any chance that you could go for dinner now and thrash things out over a can of Coke? I mean, you know what I mean? Is it past that stage?
Yes, I don't know. The problem is we're going to two different places. He's going to hell and I'm going to heaven. So I don't know whether God up there will allow me to have dinner with him or not, or allow me to visit hell, because I am going down to hell to see him.
Alt Cricket asks, Lalit, you've openly admitted manipulating the IPL auction with regards to Flintoff. Why?
I was in a problem to run the IPL, move the IPL, get it up and running. I had no idea what my friend Mr. Srinivasan wanted. He said, I want Flintoff. And I want Flintoff one way or the other. Okay? So I asked my friends, okay, he wants Flintoff. He's not going to let us go forward and do anything we want. We have a bigger agenda. And I said, in the scheming of bigger agenda, to me, one player going to one team, another team, and they want to trade each other, they're going to bother the trading. It was a smaller issue for me. I just let it go in that context.
Do you understand how, to fans, that looks like you're fixing the competition?
I didn't fix the competition.
I'm not saying individual games, but by doing that, allowing the auction to go ahead.
I was worried about the tournament going ahead in the first place. He wanted, before even the tournament approvals were coming in, there were hundreds of players out there. He wanted a particular player, and he wanted for certain, we don't know what reason he wanted. He said, I want it. And so I said to the others also wanted it. They said, okay, fine, we won't bid for him, we'll bid for another one. But none of them listened to me.
But you regret it?
Of course I regret it. And I would never do it again.
David Hopps, whatever happened to him, asks,
I have the name.
where would you most like to go on your holidays? And what would be the first thing you do to improve English 2020?
The 2020 in England will be the biggest hit. It'll be bigger than IPL. I can guarantee that. I can make that happen. And if it wasn't for people...
What would you do?
Give us details. Just in case we want to start it before you... Well, you're still out of favour. We might want to get something rolling.
I thought I was so persuasive.
England is the right market. All you have is the wrong administrator administrating it. It's the right market, and they're the like-minded people get together in England, the county chairmen. They can be bigger than anybody else. They're all in the black, their books are in the red right now. I can guarantee you right now that you can be in the black, but you got to get rid of the so-called person who doesn't want it to happen, the monster on the top.
And where do you like to go on your holidays?
Well, why do I like to go on holidays? Unfortunately, I haven't been able to travel for the last 4 years. So I did see a lot of your country, beautiful country. I've been to the Lake District, I've been up to Scotland, I've been down to Cornwall, I've been down to, in Berkshire, and I've stayed away from the Giles Clark area, whatever it's called.
Somerset. Somerset's lovely. The old batsman asks, has the ECB ever consulted you over what to do with T20? Because they've had this big campaign recently, this consultation process about what they should do. I mean, they've spoken to me, so they should have spoken to you.
Yes, what they have done, I must tell you. If you remember, we had the big Champions Trophy last year.
Yes.
I was invited by a board chairman, along with an ex-prime minister, to visit an India game with Pakistan in Birmingham. All of a sudden, I get a phone call saying, oh my God, we have a problem. You've been invited to a game. So there was immediately an email shot up, and that was the consultation I had with the ECB. And that's how they consulted with me. If they decided they would like to consult with me, and I thought about game. No, they wanted to consult with me by sending out an email to all members of the ECB that if Lalit Modi was invited to a game, he faces a ban. By virtue of his facing a ban in BCCI, you are endangering your county of having your membership revoked. I go to a cricket ground, I buy my ticket, and I'd like to see them stop me from entering one. I'm still waiting for that day. And I also take the Indian flag and fly it around so everybody sees the media places around.
It's funny though, because when I go through your gate sometimes, I do see your face up with a big cross through it.
How close did you come to setting up an EPL in England?
I wasn't planning to set up an EPL in England at all. I had 9 county chairmen who came to me and said, can you advise us what we should do with EPL?
Because they wanted, they saw the success that you
they
had.
They saw the success. I said, come and I don't have time for this, but you come to me, sit with me, and I'll sit with you and I'll tell you how to launch it.
Would it have been a franchise of the IPL, basically? Would you have had a slice of it?
No. It would be owned by the ECB.
Not the ECB.
Or the MCC or whoever it was.
Maybe, yeah.
But whoever it was, it was English.
Well, it wasn't the ECB, was it? Because they were very anti it.
Now, 9 county chairmen coming to me and saying, Lalit, what should we do? I said, in my view, you should do this. Have you got ECB approval? You should. You should get them approval. So which market are you targeting? We're targeting the India market. I said, forget about it. If you're going to target the India market, you're not going to get no traction out there. You should be targeting the UK market. And if you don't build it in the UK market, where are you going to build it for?
Bhavra Gosra, I haven't pronounced that right at all. But he says, India are touring England this summer. What's your prediction?
England have done extremely well on their home turf. And we have done extremely well on our home turf. And we've seen England get Australia doing extremely well on their home turf. So I guess home turf wickets are favouring the home team, which they should. So it's going to be an interesting tour.
Although England did win in India, of course.
I know. Yes, they did, actually. What was the score that you finally ended up in Australia with?
Well, I don't know about what you mean we. It was 5-0. Australia won.
That's how I remember it, too.
Pavilion Opinions asks, any news on the Rajasthan Cricket Association's suspension, or BCCI's suspension, following your election as its president?
I really don't care. I occupy the chair. My name is outside the door.
How do you know, though? You haven't been back to check. They probably just told you that. You might not even be...
My secretary is there.
Oh, okay. Uh-huh.
We had loads and loads of questions, and thank you for sending those. The show doesn't work without them. We're very grateful. And you've answered them brilliantly. We can't take up any more of your time, but thank you very much.
Thank you.
Really enjoyable. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, and we'll be back next week with another show.